Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So Jesus is with us. Jesus is today with us. Our God is a God who changes the situations. When Jesus resides in our heart, everything will be changed. Our character will be changed. Our house will be changed. Everything will be changed. So today, this time also, Holy Spirit told me to share with you about the words from John, 1 John chapter 3, second verse. It says, "Dear friends, we are now God's children, but what we will be like has not been revealed yet. We know that when the Messiah is revealed, we will be like him, because we will see him as he is." Hallelujah. So, can you give a loud hallelujah to God?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, today this time, I am happy to stand before you because God has given me the privilege to share the word with you. So, those who are watching also, and those who are here, those who are in the fasting prayer, I pray in the name of Jesus, let this word be a blessing and deliverance to each and everybody. Hallelujah. So, the book of 1 John, chapter 2nd verse, it is saying, "Dear friends, we are now God's children." How many God's children are here? The verse is saying there, "Dear friends, we are now God's children." If you are God's children, if you confess that you are a child of God, if you admit that you are a child of God, then what problem you have? You have no problem, because your Father is Heavenly Father. He is the Father who created the earth, universe, everything. He named the stars. So if that Father is your Father, if the Heavenly Father is your Father, then what do you bother about anything? Whatever problem that comes in your life, it doesn't matter. It won't affect you, because that Father is your Heavenly Father. Because you are a God's son. The book of John chapter 1, 12th verse, it says that God has given us the authority to become the children of God. Those who accept him and believe him, God has given the authority to become the children of, child of God. So we should not bow down before anybody. We should be bold. We should have the courage, because we have got the Spirit of God. We have got the Spirit of Jesus. We should not be ashamed of anything. Nothing will happen to us. No problem will affect us, because whatever that comes in our life, everything will, God will be. Hallelujah. When we read the book of Ephesians chapter 1, 19th verse, Paul is praying for the people of, for the believers of Ephesians, for the church of Ephesians. That Paul is praying for to let the understanding be open. Let the understanding be open for them. Hallelujah. Let the people, Paul's prayer for the church is that let them have the understanding. How they understand the God. If you know who your God, if you know who your who Jesus is, you won't be afraid, because Jesus and his disciples were traveling in the boat. We know that very well. When heavy storm and tempest came, you know, Jesus was lying there, Jesus was sleeping, but the disciples were frightened. They shook Jesus and said, "We are going to get drowned. We are going to get drowned. We are going to be killed in the sea." They cried loudly, but Jesus didn't bother. What happened? What happened in the surroundings? Jesus didn't bother, because he was sleeping quietly, because he knows that Heavenly Father is the Father of Jesus. Jesus knows, and Jesus is the child. Hallelujah. So, we are, the verse is saying, "Dear friends, we are now God's children. But what we will be like has not been revealed yet." What we will be has not been revealed yet. A great thing is going to happen in your life, sir.
Thank you, Mahdi.
Something great is going to happen in your life. That has not been revealed yet. It is only going to be revealed. How many of you believe that?
Hallelujah.
How many of you believe that? It is only going to be revealed. Hallelujah. Because God called you and God is faithful. God called all the Israelites. But only a few people were able to enter the promised land.
Hallelujah.
So what we will be like has not been revealed. The verse is saying like that.
Hallelujah.
So the verse further I am reading that we know that when the Messiah is revealed, we will be like him because we will see him as he is. The verse is saying that when we see Jesus as he is, Messiah will be revealed. People are not seeing Jesus as Jesus is. The disciples were traveling with Jesus in a boat when heavy storm came. When there was heavy storm and heavy tempest, the disciples were frightened because they are not knowing that the Son of God is with them. They are not knowing that the Son of God is. When the heavy tempest came, the disciples were frightened because they were not sure, they were not aware that this is the Son of God.
Hallelujah.
So if it is the Son of God, why you are not afraid? Why you are afraid of anything? Because if you are a child of God, why you are afraid of all your circumstances, all the what all are happening in your area, in your neighborhood? Nothing will come and affect you because you are a child of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. If you are a child of God, you do not lack anything because Psalms 23:1 says, I do not want. Lord is my shepherd, I do not want. How many of you believe that? If you are a child of God, because the verse is saying, I am reading once again, 1 John 3:2, it says, dear friends, we are now God's children. We are now God's children, but what we will be like has not been revealed yet. We know that when the Messiah is revealed, we will be like him because we will see